Welcome into another telecast of LMC Varsity Sports alongside Rob Moretti. I'm Charlie McGraw. We're here for homecoming as the Clarkstown North Rams get set to face the Mamaroneck Tigers. And this should be a good game, Rob. Clarkstown North, though, is having a very good season at 3-0. And they've only allowed 8 points, but Mamaroneck's defense is no pushover either.
That's right. The Tigers are 0-3, but the defense has kept them in their games. They really haven't gotten blown out. They haven't lost by more than 14 points. And really, their 14-point loss against Mayapak was mostly on the special teams anyway. Mamaroneck also is getting Bill Flato back behind center, we believe, tonight. So that could help their offense, which has really been struggling.
Definitely. We'll see if Flato can boost the offense. And when we get back, we'll have the opening kickoff here on LMC Varsity Sports.
Gentlemen, as captains, you're the leaders of the team. We're going to give you the respect that you've earned. You've been selected as a captain because someone thinks you're a leader. We're going to give you that respect. Now, if we have a penalty, then ask the captain of the offended team to come over. I will explain all of your options to you. If you need me to explain them again, I will. And if you need help from your coach, you can ask your coach for help on making a decision. Once you've made your decision, it's fine. As visitors, you're going to cool it. That's a head. That's a tail. I'm going to flip it up and then hit the ground. What are you going to call it?
That's it.
Heads?
That's it.
Those heads. It's a tail. You have won the toss. You want to receive. What goal do you want to defend? Put your back on that line over there, please. Right here. We'll receive. Okay, guys, let's shake hands. Let's have a good game.
Oh, good.
Kicking well during warm-ups, and another beauty. This one fielded at the 5, and running into each other was the return man, number 5 from Mamaroneck, Kiefer Barchetti, as Barchetti, a little miscommunication there.
Yeah, a little misstep there from Barchetti, but yeah, Finkelstein was drilling 40-plus yard field goals in pregame warm-ups, and that's not the same as hitting them during a game. You don't have a rush coming at you. No one trying to block it, but still an impressive leg on Finkelstein. We'll see if that plays a factor later in the game.
So Bill Flato will be back. We haven't seen. He hasn't been the Mamaroneck's quarterback since the first half of game number 1 that you saw here on LMC Varsity Sports against Mayapak. He threw a touchdown pass in that game. Or, no, they led a touchdown drive.
And they were like a blanket.
It was a screen pass to Peter Matt, if I recall.
Right, who's injured and hurt his leg in a game against Horace Greeley. So he's not playing in this one. So we'll see if that, how much of Matt missing is a factor. First play, and he's passing, and he completes it to Patrick Cotter. He almost breaks a tackle, gets there, and nearly a first half short by 3 yards. Good first play to see that the arm's good for Flato. And like you tweeted, Rob, nice spiral.
Yeah, Flato, the issue coming in was how is that shoulder, and will he be able to throw with his full accuracy and with his full force? And it looks like he is able to do so, at least early on.
And the injury against Mayapak came against a big hit where it hurt his collarbone, and he hurt his shoulder, and it was his throwing shoulder, and we could see on the sidelines that game that he was trying to throw, and he couldn't, but he missed. So 2.5 games as he came out right at the end, about 2 minutes left, as that will be run for a yard by the back Barchetti, as it'll be 3rd and 2 from their own 26. And definitely, Rob, being out 2.5 games has to affect him a little, but we'll see what play they run here.
3 wide, looks like they might be set up for a pass play.
As wide is Cotter on this side, and stacked on the other side.
It's Genovese and Pineros is in the slot.
As they'll go to Cotter. Cotter's open, and that'll be a first down to the 33, taken down by Kevin Sheridan. And he gave him that opening, and Flato saw it right away, and Cotter gets it. And Rob, this is a 3-0 Clarkstown North team. Only let up 8 points against their arch rivals, Clarkstown South, in game number one. And every other game, they two shutouts against Greeley and Mayapak, two teams that beat Mamaroneck, which didn't have Flato at quarterback those games.
That is true. It's interesting to see Mamaroneck's offense, how much it's changed just through the 4 weeks of the season based on who's in and who's out.
Flato was replaced by Peter Salamini on the first game he was out. The second game, but last game he was replaced by Cardin, and that one will be 5 yards by Genovese on the pitch. And it'll be a 2nd and 5 as Emerson Genovese with the run. As it was a good play there, first run for Genovese. They should go to him more often on the ground.
And with Peter Matt out, Genovese is their playmaker on offense.
Besides Flato.
Well, it takes two for Flato to make a play.
As it'll be Flato, he'll get the snap here, 2nd and 5, and he'll throw, and he'll have it. He's 3 for 3 is Flato, and he'll run over a player, will be back Justin Pineros. So the fullback Pineros missed the completion, 3 for 3 for 15, 20 yards, Rob, and he's looked good in returning.
Certainly the guy who has to run this offense. Mamaroneck came into the season expecting to be pass heavy, then Flato got hurt. They had to go to the run. It wasn't very effective. Their season high in points was last week against Greeley, that they scored 14. Obviously a tall order against this Clarkstown North defense this week. But Flato is one of the top QBs in the state, so he can get some plays made.
Greeley, yeah, they went to Julian Harden, that quarterback, last week. He's a wide receiver. And they lost 16-14 that game, and it'll be handed off to Barchetti, and he'll get maybe a yard or two, and it'll be 2nd and 8 at midfield. As the only non-common opponent between these two teams is Clarkstown South for Clarkstown North in the 26-8 win, and the powerhouse, New Rochelle, which Mamaroneck, that looks very good, a 14-6 loss, Rob.
Yeah, they played well that game, but like I said, they just could not get enough going on offense in that game, and that's why they lost 14-6.
9 minutes to go here in the first quarter, midfield, as Mamaroneck will have it, 2nd and 8, and a pass is batted up in the air, and it'll be incomplete. First time they got pressure that good on Flato when they got to him, and first incompletion as he's now 3 for 4 passing, and that was dangerous.
He's lucky that wasn't intercepted. It was floating up there a long time. Give Henry Bruce credit. He kind of, like he was a center on the basketball team, boxed everyone out.
Mr. Adams, it's no one, guys. Guys, I and let it fall safely. Okay, good job by the junior tight end, Bruce. For Mamaroneck, 3rd and 9. We'll see what Coach Vitti, Anthony Vitti, calls here.
As Coach Joe Tran
Gone is the head coach for Clarkstown North. His team,
as mentioned, is 3-0.
And Anthony Vitti's team, 0-3. Plato escapes trouble. He'll get past a couple of defenders, but he'll be short at the 45. It'll be 4th and 3. Good job by Plato to elude some defenders there. Not as nobody was open on the 3rd and 6, and 3rd and 9, and he was able to avoid the sack.
Looks like they're going for the punt here. They took a second to make the decision, but deciding they're a little bit too far for 4-down territory, they're going to punt it away.
Not to give anything away, but if I remember correctly, when they ran 2 fake punts, the call from the sidelines was assassin, and that was the call just now. So we'll see what we got here, but it will be a punt, and heads-up play there by Mamaroneck's Zion Powell, as Powell will save it from going 5-10 yards backwards, as the punt was only 20 yards by Emerson Genovese.
And not a bad punt, just didn't have the right spin. Took a big Rams bounce.
A great play by Powell, as Powell was able to save it from going maybe 5-10 more yards.
Definitely a heads-up play. First look at the Clarkstown offense here, and they've scored 26, 36, and 21 in their 3 games, so they've been putting up the points.
And that's good for 83, as they're led by quarterback senior Jack Abrams, and he will hand off to the big halfback. It's 5'8", but 175 looks a little bigger than that, maybe 180. And that was Porco, Michael Porco, the senior. He was stopped by a couple guys in Tommy Williams and Daniel O'Rourke. So we got 7:35 to go. It'll be 2nd and 7, Rob, and we'll see Clarkstown North what they elect here on their second play.
So what kind of playbook they run. Abrams under center.
Abrams, a generous 6'1", 185, and they'll hand it to Kyle O'Neill. Small team offensively. O'Neill, 5'9", 107 halfback. He's got that 17 number, like a wide receiver, too. As it'll be 3rd and 1 from Clarkstown North's 39, as they just need to get it to the 40, their own 40 for a first down, as Mamaroneck's defense led up front by Eddie Sirocco, Tommy Williams, co-captains. We'll see if they can get a big stop here, as they will just get the first down. O'Neill will sneak on the running back play there to the running back O'Neill for 2 yards, as he just got past the line of scrimmage, and it'll be a Rams first down, as they'll have 1st and 10 from their own 41.
Tigers did what they could there. It looked like they sent pretty much an all-out blitz and just able to sneak through and move the chains.
Stuart Williamson and the safeties and cornerbacks coming up with a big hit on the end around. No gain, 2nd and 10.
That's so important, too, because that's who you need to get to those end around plays. You need the safeties and your defensive backs to sniff that play out and do so quickly, or else that burner can be gone.
So it'll be 2nd and 10. Abrams will get the snap, and he'll be sacked. Going for a 3-yard loss by several Tigers, led by the Henry Bruce, the defensive end. As Rob alluded to, the nice box out he did on that play for tight end, and now Bruce getting in on the sack as he led it. And it'll be 3rd and 12, and a huge play coming up here. I haven't seen the pass yet from Clarkstown North and Abrams. We'll see what, definitely a passing situation. 3rd and 12, and they're running.
running it again to the back, and they'll stop him short of the first down. Gained about 8 or 9, Dave, on the quick give to Michael Porco. So it'll be fourth down and a little. Bring in the punting unit, and their all-around leg, Ben Finkelstein, as he kicks, punts, and kicks off, as Mamaroneck has one of those, but Alvarez does not punt, as Emerson Genovese does. But they're former soccer players, now playing football. Finkelstein, he looked good in warm-up, though, hitting 45-yarders. Rod liked his punts, too. Definitely, so we'll see Finkelstein here on fourth and four from their own 47 and a wobbly snap, which we saw during warm-ups as well. Flag on the play, fair catch, and
I think Genovese did that for safety, because that's probably a false start against Clarkstown North.
And it was, it looks like. As Coach David Smith, assistant coach, you could hear him saying that. As
looks like the offense is coming out, but shouldn't that be a re-kick? Unless they decline the penalty.
Yeah, so it'll be a... Yeah, full start on the punt.
It was a nice punt, too. I'd make him kick it again, but...
I mean, it's on the 21. The only thing is the way Finkelstein's been punting.
That was a strong punt.
Vitti declined it. Just signaled decline. So, Clarkstown North has their kicker still on the field. They don't know what Mamaroneck is going to do. And Finkelstein will head to the sidelines. It'll be 21. They must figure Finkelstein's a good punter. Vitti actually saw him on the warm-ups, and that punt was about 35 yards, 33. Good play by Genovese, though, to fair catch. They could have downed that. If he didn't fair catch that, they might have downed that, and then you do have him re-kick, because you push him back 5 yards. Either way, it's... tough choice, but Fredo back for a second series returning. Picked up a couple first downs before they had a punt. Both teams exchanging punts here. Once again, Mamaroneck 0-3, Clarkstown North 3-0, and it's bobbled on the far sidelines, but then caught a la Ruben Randall last night, although that was a deflection, Rob, but that was Genovese making that play.
Usually sure-handed. That time he was sure-handed enough. The Tigers are going to throw the ball a lot, especially, like I was saying earlier, they came into the season expecting to be a pass-heavy team. You lose Flato for all that time. You have to go run-heavy. It's not happening. Now Matt's hurt. So,
second and one for Mamaroneck. Flato will get it. Looks like so far, we've never seen Clarkstown North's offense, but it looks like two tails of the tape, the run, ground and pound for Clarkstown North, and the throw from Mamaroneck, as the run does not work. He loses his helmet, does Barchetti, and the play is dead. Good call by the officials.
That's a safety rule.
Barchetti escaped the tackle, and he was on his feet, but since he lost his helmet, safety issues, you have to blow it dead, and they'll bring it back to the line of scrimmage for third and one. That could be dangerous.
Didn't Jeremy Shockey once score a touchdown without his helmet on the NFL?
And then he threw it, right? After, and they gave him a big penalty? When he was with the Saints, not with the
Giants.
Might
have happened with the Giants, I don't know.
We gotta look that up.
Maybe
later.
It happened twice.
Now the officials, they don't know the rule. Do they replay the down?
And the question is, do you replay the down, or is it dead at the spot and the down counts? There's a flag down now. Is it unsportsmanlike against Clarkstown? I'm not sure what the call was. It's against Clarkstown. They're
maybe
the
because
the
of
first
the play
down.
That took his helmet off, an unsportsmanlike hit?
It was a late flag for that, though. It
maybe
was about 2 minutes
they
ago.
They discussed it. Well, I'm not sure. What else could it have been, Rob?
It's a 15-yarder, so it's either a personal foul or
an unsportsmanlike
or an unsportsmanlike for something that was said. It looked like 2 minutes after the play they threw the flag.
Well, because they might have discussed how his helmet came off, because a guy's helmet's not supposed to come off, like, legally. Face mask could rip it off, and that's a penalty, as they'll slow it down with the offense. Clock running with 3:15 to go here in the first quarter.
They'll snap this pretty soon.
They will, and they'll fake the handoff. Flato will elude a couple defenders, and Hale will elude one, but a flag on the play.
And it looked like a legal block on Mamaroneck.
That's probably what it is that's going to come
about
back.
9 yards, and it looks like it'll come back 3-3 to go.
On the positive side, though, you've got to, like, knowing how Bill Flato got hurt, scrambling, landing on his arm, you love the fearlessness he's showing. He's not afraid to take off and run with the football.
He's zigzagging great. He's really moving in and out of the defense good. He's not afraid. I don't think he lost a step of it. He's a little more cautious. It looks like in his running, a little more cautious. Make sure, you know, the defenders aren't, that he's not open to get hit like that. I mean,
nothing,
it wasn't his
there's
fault.
There's nothing wrong with trying to be more elusive.
For sure. It wasn't his fault when he got hit like that, but it was. He definitely looks like a little more cautious. Because it'll be a legal holding.
Yeah, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. That'll make it a first and 16, it looks like.
As it occurred about 4 yards from past it. So they replay the down, though, which is good for Mamaroneck. And it'll be Flato will have it here.
Trips right.
Looking for the offense as Cotter is stacked to the right, along with Bruce. And Panaros. Flato will get it, and they'll throw again, and he'll hit Panaros, close to the first down, second catch for Panaros. Now Flato is now 4 for 5, passing, 2 to Panaros, 1 to Genovese, who's looked like, besides Peter Matt, was his top target. Genovese has 1. And Panaros has another one as well.
Patrick Cotter had a couple of catches as well early on.
Yeah, Cotter had 1. Panaros has 1. Or Panaros has 2 and Genovese has 1.
Well, what a clock stoppage for a measurement here. So it's going to be close. Now we'll stick around and watch this measurement.
Definitely.
It's if the stick is right, then I think they might have it by the nose of the football, but we'll see. Close. Not quite. Yard short.
Hi, Garrett.
It's still a nice play there. Panaros yards after the catch as well, running tough. Listed as a fullback, but they've been using him more like a slot back, split end. He's been getting looks really all over the offense, and turning into a key player.
About an inch or two short. Huge crowd here for homecoming. Almost topping the crowd in the opener, where Mayapak brought about 100 people here. Clarkstown North, not as much. We saw the cheerleaders come 8 minutes before the game.
Well, they filled up that away section of stands pretty well.
Which is only about,
the
away section has about seats for 30, and this section has about for 300.
Oh, there is a huge difference in capacity.
Right, as Flato will be in shotgun. They've been in shotgun for every snap. So that's the offense they run with Bill Flato. He will hand it off, and it'll be a first down on the first carry for Daniel O'Rourke. So O'Rourke gained 6 yards on his first carry of the game. Good play there, and a lot of guys getting in on the action now.
Yeah, with Peter Matt out, you're going to see them substituting more of their depth in, especially at running back in the positions that Matt plays. Just to keep the fresh legs in there, you might as well take that advantage if you've got guys you can trust.
As Matt is listed as a split back, see him line up as a running back, wide receiver. You saw him take the onside kick and recover it. Matt will get the signal as they're playing this offense where they get it and then they no huddle, get to the line and they call a play at the line. So second and completion to Williamson, and it'll be 4 for 6 now, and that one's incomplete. Flato has looked good, Rob, though, and no signs of slowing down for him yet.
This is what the Tigers need. They need some sort of hope this season. because of the new playoff system. They know they're going to the playoffs, so get your guys healthy, get them back, get them in a groove, and hit the ground running when the postseason comes.
And if there's a big amount of time later that we have, Rob will explain the playoff system, maybe?
Best I can. It's a little confusing. They're trying something new this year.
Basically, it's because of their preseason ranking, which the coaches all came up with as the pass is completed to Cotter, number two. Reception for Cotter as it was second and 10, and he'll get right to the first down marker. It'll be about maybe third and one. 159 remaining, but because of their preseason ranking, that's why they have the playoff guarantee,
right,
which
top
the coaches
13,
came up with.
Well, somewhat. It was combined previous season's results, how many seniors you've lost. I'm not sure all the factors that go into that.
It was like bracketology almost.
Somewhat. But America's the top 13 preseason, so they have a seed in that new round of 16 qualifying round.
Was Kevin Devaney from MSC Varsity part of that bracketology?
He should have been.
Definitely. We'll have a timeout. Coach Anthony Vitti has a little miscommunication there. And it'll be 1:27 left in the first. A third, and scoreboard says four, but it's more like two here on LMC Varsity Sports. Back here on LMC Varsity Sports, 1:27 left. A third and two for Mamaroneck as Bill Flato will get the snap and shotgun. Barchetti was back, and a short pass uncharacteristically thrown by Flato. I never see a guy him miss like that much. As he had Pinero's wide open, but he short hopped him.
Now you wonder if he expected Pinero's to break off that route a little sooner. Maybe it was one of those plays where it's all about timing, and the timing was off. I'm not really sure.
With the ball on the 30.
And this is four down territory. They're going for it.
Clarkstown North's 32. They will go for it here, fourth and two. Can't punt too long of a field goal for Alvarez. And Flato will be by himself back there, but might scramble for it if he has to.
See if the defense gives. He only need a couple yards.
Five wide receivers wide, fourth and two. He's got his man, and it's complete to Williamson. And he is hit hard out of bounds. First down to Stuart Williamson. Nice play, and
good job by Flato to put the bad pass behind him, Rob.
Absolutely, and a perfect bullet to Williamson. Nice catch. Send the cheerleaders scrambling a little bit down there.
Clarkstown's cheerleaders.
Well, we don't want anyone getting hurt.
The late arriving Clarkstown North cheerleaders.
We're on time. They got here 10 minutes before kickoff. It's good enough.
It's probably traffic, you know? Everyone's coming
in. They're coming across the bridge.
For the Pope.
As it'll be.
We've made a Pope reference. We can't undo that.
As getting out of bounds was Williamson on his first catch, second time he was targeted. And a flip on the end around. And Genevieve shakes off the first tackler, but gets hit about a yard later by Cameron Conrad. And he will lose 2 yards, a yard as opposed to two or three if he had gotten hit. Took the initial hit.
It was a good play by Genevieve. They're able to spin out of some contact, but just too many white jerseys there.
Weird way that they pitched the way, like a disguising it almost.
Almost did it with two hands on that pitch.
Did
the way.
But over the top on that pitch.
It almost looked like they were going to go for a flea flicker.
As Vitti will call in, Coach Vitti will call in the play. 30 seconds left. He'll get the snap. Will Flato on second and 11. A scramble to the left. And it'll be complete to Williamson on the far side of the field. Two catches in a row for Williamson. As
the second passing play that he caught in a row, play before that was in between, was that run.
It'll be third and two. 11-yard pass there, Flato to Williamson.
And don't forget, this is definitely four-down territory.
Once again, as it was before, as they completed the pass on the fourth down, that was the play.
And on that second down, they went back to Williamson.
Good play in traffic, too, and threading the needle was Flato on that pass.
They'll run it up, and they'll get the...
I think he got it.
Very close, and it looks like he will get it. And that was Barchetti, Kiefer Barchetti with the 3-yard run. And they'll set the chains as it'll be first and 10 from Clarkstown North, 14. One play left for the half looks like as Flato will get the snap.
The clock running now, though, they might just let it run down. They would just stop the clock to move the sticks.
Or if you quick snap it.
Nah, that could only throw you off, as they will.
We'll end the first quarter here, and
we mentioned the defense is in the get-go. Coming into this game, Clarkstown North only allowed 8 points.
Mamaroneck only allowed the most, 21 in one game.
Both teams have great defenses so far, showing. Mamaroneck has first and 10 for their own 14. When we get back, Rob will have the play-by-play here on LMC Varsity Sports.
Rob already here along with Charlie McGraw. Tigers with the ball first and 10 on the 14-yard line.
Two teams switch fields, and this side, we were just talking about it, seems a little, lights aren't as bright over here.
Well, there is a reason for that. We'll get to it after the play. Flato takes the snap, goes out for Williamson, who is, I'm sorry, that was Cotter, got tripped up, short gain.
Just the point is the lights. It was tough to tell who that was, because it was Williamson, not Cotter, but it has to do with the house.
Yeah, there are some houses behind the field, and they got upset that the lights were hitting their backyards. They had a kind of angle them away from there a little bit, but yeah, inside the 15-10 yard line on that side, it gets a little dark.
Almost more than a little.
In some spots, kind of dark.
Other side, it's
pretty good. Yeah. No one cares about the lights on the post.
Which
road.
Was surprising that they didn't run the play, that last play, because...
Well, second down and six. Three wide. Bruce also split out from his tight end position. Barchetti in the backfield. And now he'll come stand next to Flato.
As just getting it
rolls out to his left. Heaves it into the end zone. Genovese! Does he catch it? Touchdown!
What a catch by Emerson Genovese on the triple bobble. He had a bobble catch earlier, but that was unbelievable, Rob.
Emerson Genovese with the David Tyree special. I'm pretty sure that one went off his helmet. I am a little surprised they ruled him in bounds, to be honest, but I'm sure Tigers will take it.
In high school, you just need one. And the kicker going on the field, Alvarez.
They'll go with the funky moving line set. They need the long snapper Jason Velastro to get out there, though.
As earlier in the game, they bobbled the ball, and he caught it to Genovese, but not like that one. He bobbled it off the left, bobbled it off the helmet.
Oh, we've got a trick play. Snap to O'Rourke. Does he get it in? No good. Tackle just short. And that's why they do that. So it was a direct snap to O'Rourke, who I guess was listed as an eligible receiver. He was able to receive the snap. He tried to run it in with a line in front of him. It just didn't work.
And Coach Vitti is not happy with...
I think because they had the look they wanted. When you have a wall in front of you, you should be able to make it.
His lineman, yeah. He's not happy with the lineman blocking there, as they... didn't block it. He just missed getting that. But on that play, Vitti thinks he should easily get it, and he should have. But O'Rourke did a great job, and he didn't get the blocks. But now we know maybe why they only scored six against New Rochelle. They probably tried that against New Rochelle.
That's possible.
I mean, I think he just kicked them. I don't like that play, because I know it's saying after they miss it, but...
Well, I think what they do is they line up, and if they see the look they want, they go for it. And they saw the look they wanted. Otherwise, they could always audible it into a kick.
Salamini sprinted out there like trying to prevent the holder. Sprinted out there like trying to prevent Clarkstown North from challenging. Obviously, you can't do that in high school. And Alvarez just came out. You know, I guess he was getting the some extra kicks on the sidelines. We'll see what they do here, Alvarez. Clarkstown North, they saw game film. They're ready for a little onside, but now they spread out as they do here, and we'll see what Alvarez goes with.
Alvarez lines it up. Just a minute gone by, second quarter.
Squib.
Medium kick, takes a bounce, picked up. Rushing through the middle, I believe that was Pauly Termine. Pretty nice return. Tough hop to handle off the ground, too.
Yeah, good play by Termine, and he'll get good field position to start. 32, we'll see if they throw a pass here, because they have not yet compared to Mamaroneck 7.
And how about Mamaroneck? The first points scored on Clarkstown North since week one.
They're trying to match Clarkstown South's 8 points right there.
I'm sure they want to beat that handily.
I just feel when you have, like, when the other team has a great kicker like Finkelstein, you guys automatic on extra points. If Clarkstown, if they score here, then you got to go for two again as well. Wow.
Tough running from Pauly Termeen.
Three times it looked like he was down.
Ended up with a short gain, but that could have been a loss. He was swarmed in the backfield.
So with Peter Matt out, we figured it would be a game where Emerson Genovese would have a big one, and so far he has.
From that touchdown, yeah.
On a really special catch with the fingertips and the helmet.
It was very close. All you need is that 1 foot, Rob, and it was very close.
And the ref made it quickly, too, the call, maybe 2 or 3 seconds.
He was right on top of it.
Man in motion. It's a pitch. Porco snuffed out by Mamaroneck for a loss.
Clarkstown North, they're going to have to go to something else as Mamaroneck knows the run's coming, and they're ready as they... On the other series, this is their second full series taking over, but before when they had got that big third down on that sack, they picked it up. But here as well, third and 10, 9:35 to go. Mamaroneck up 6-0.
Back to the original line of scrimmage now. They go with a tight set. Porco in motion, rolling out, completed to Termeen. He's got a first down.
And he stepped out about 5 yards.
Or does he? That's a close.
Before.
That is
no,
close.
He got it. He got it. He's good.
I thought he was a little further off the field, but
he was, but they
got him a yard past the marker.
He stepped down.
Well, he has a much better view of that than we do, so we'll trust the ref. That'll move the sticks for the Rams. Abrams under center, double fake, and Abrams keeps it near side. Being chased by Zion Powell, puts a stiff arm and finally dives out of bounds with a little help from Julian Houghton.
Two fakes and still the run. So they're option, run, slash trickery, all on runs, no passing yet. Has Clarkstown North back-to-back first downs here. They're in business. Interesting to see how many passes he has attempted Abrams on the season, because we haven't seen one yet.
He went back to pass once, but he got sacked.
I think twice, too, another time as well, and he scrambled away.
This time it's a give to O'Neal. It's Kyle O'Neal for a good game, about 5 yards. Second down and 5.
Let's see what Coach Joe Trangone throws at Mamaroneck here. Second and 5. Mamaroneck is a
tight wing set.
Straight run.
Double fake. It's a handoff to Termeen. I think he's got enough for the first.
He does. As he was taken down there by O'Rourke, but they're
good runs there with the reverse before they reversed,
and they just went to Termeen. But before that, when they reversed, Abrams kept it. So
they're throwing so many different runs at Mamaroneck, it's getting a little challenging.
A little misdirection style offense can work in high school.
34-yard line of the Tigers, too. They're marching.
Another misdirection play to Porco. Positive yardage.
Three different guys got the misdirection runs. Actually, four. O'Neal, Termeen, Porco, and quarterback, Abrams, on the misdirection runs that they've run in the last 4 or 5 plays.
Actually somewhat reminiscent of Ryan Eck's offense. Run a little bit more quicker paced.
Ryan Eck does throw a little more.
Not this year. Second down, 5. Handoff O'Rourke met at the line. Sorry, O'Neal met at the line and pushes forward. He's close to a first down.
As coming with the blitz was Kieran Thwaite,
and he couldn't get it. And it looks to be
a about a yard short, maybe a yard and a half.
Favorable spot for Mamaroneck, and it'll be third and one. Huge play from the 25. We saw Finkelstein in
hit field goals from about this distance. So
the only thing is, if it's like fourth and one,
they might just go for it.
Yeah, they'll go for it.
But we'll see what happens on a third down play.
They tackle him for a loss, maybe.
It's O'Neal right up the middle. He's got it.
Give the offensive line credit. Not the biggest offensive line for a double-A school, but
they're getting the job done on the ground right now.
This is exactly what we expected for the most part, a defensive battle. Not a whole lot of points going up on the board, but teams putting together good drives. No huge plays aside from the Genovese touchdown catch. Ooh, double fake.
Wow.
Termine. That's a pretty big play.
A huge fake. It looks like, O'Neal got it.
But no, O'Neal did not. Termine did. And he gets 15 yards. It'll be first and goal. First and goal from the 10.
About as far as you can be to be first and goal. And right on the 10-yard line. Where was this offense during their first drive? It's misdirection really working. Let's give to O'Neal. Short gain up the middle.
As Coach Joe Trangone realized for Clarkstown North that the Rams, that it wasn't working on Mamaroneck, so he had to dig deeper into his playbook, and that's when the misdirection comes in, as Mamaroneck will take a timeout, and we'll step aside and be right back.
That is 6:14 to go in the first half. Tigers clinging to a 6-0 lead, and we'll be right back on LMC Varsity Sports as Clarkstown North is marching. Second and goal from the 5.
So we're back, Clarkstown, with a second and goal from the 6-yard line. Tigers trying to make a stand here, limit them to a field goal try. Flag on the play, and it's not blown dead. But placed alive, they haven't blown the whistle, and finally they do. That was some weird confusion there, Charlie.
Yeah, because the quarterback,
that play should have been blown dead.
Abrams thought it was blown dead, and the officials never really did blow it dead. And the illegal motion,
it should have been.
Confusion all around here on that play.
So that'll march it back 5 yards.
As the officials have to discuss that. Second and goal now for them.
They were on the 5.
They were on the 6, I think. I don't know what the ball's doing on the 14. Is it a 10-yard penalty?
Illegal motion's a 5-yard penalty.
Right, that's not right. That's a 9-yard penalty? That can't be right. 8-yard penalty? Something's not right.
The official has to explain.
That's not proper enforcement there. That should be a 5-yard penalty with the ball on the 11, I believe. Oh, I see. The penalty was declined. They're going to take the result of the play. That's a sack.
It's a smart move by Coach Vitti.
Well, he probably asked, what happens if I decline it? Oh, yes, let's do that. Loss of down as well. So third down and goal from the 15.
Now they will switch the downs.
Abrams did not know what had happened. Now the coaches from Clarkstown North, all six of them, are listening to the explanation from the officials.
I don't know why they didn't blow it dead, but since the even
they are supposed to blow that dead, aren't they? So I think the question is, if you were supposed to blow it dead, how are they allowed to decline the penalty and take the result of the play when there shouldn't have been a play? But they allowed there to be a play. So that, I think that's the point of confusion and contention here.
Yeah, and Clarkstown North is saying, well, if that should have been the case, why was it even offered? Because it should have been blown dead. There should have, the decline shouldn't have been an option.
Looks like we're about ready to go.
That'll take a good 3 or 4 minutes,
give or take. Yeah, good delay here after that unusual play. Just waiting for Abrams to come into the huddle here. He's making his way out. 6:05 to go in the first half. Tigers up 6-0 here on homecoming night. And that is the call. A penalty was declined. Third down and goal from the 14.
He signaled for a legal motion.
I know in the NFL they blew that down. Anyway, 3rd and 14. It's a give. Termeen up the middle. He's not going to get enough. Down around the 7.
We'll see if the good kicker Finkelstein.
We'll see if they kick it or if they decide. They could still decide to go for it and give Mamaroneck the poor field position if they don't make it. Haven't seen Finkelstein come on the field, so.
No, he's not. He's not. They're going for it, Rob. 5:40 left. 4th and goal from the 6.
It's 5 or 6. Hard to tell from here.
6.
Looks like the ball's right between the 5 and 6 hash marks, so.
Huge play coming up, regardless, Rob.
Abrams under center, man in motion. Abrams keeps. Abrams hit from behind, and he's down with a sack. Tigers get the ball back on downs.
Led by a gang of tacklers, Zion Powell, Jake Magnoli, Eddie Sirocco, and it'll be first down Tigers on a very questionable play call by Clarkstown North. I know you haven't thrown all game, but still, that's not the play.
The Tigers' pass rush has been so effective the few times they have tried to throw that you almost wonder when you should try it again. Certainly not there.
With their kicker, as Coach David Smith is fired up on the sidelines, he's also the girls' varsity basketball coach.
I don't know if he gets that fired up during the basketball season.
No, he does not.
Not quite as much. We've seen him get hot.
So they'll take over 1st and 10 from their 13.
Flato's got 3 wide.
7-yard sack. So even with that sack and taking it, you don't really pin him that as deep as
Flato hits Cotter. First down.
As you were saying, they were thinking, you know, pinning them deep with the 6 if they stopped. That's why you got to pass it, too, because if you throw an incomplete pass, it's on the 6-yard line. As opposed to, and the way Mamaroneck runs the ball, if you get a sack, it's almost a safety because they're always in the shotgun. So, I don't know. Nevertheless, Clarkstown North is still 3-0 and Mamaroneck 0-3.
Mamaroneck looking to change that here.
Cotter split out wide right.
Tigers are
Genovese wide left, and then Williamson in the slot. Bruce about a step off the tight end position. Flato will throw, a little pressure, takes off, and he is sacked behind the line.
Linemen weren't able to contain the D there, including number Kenichi Oti. Samili.
See if the Tigers go for the throw again, 2nd and long.
Marchetti will be in the backfield.
Same package, except Williamson is now wide and Genovese in the slot.
Tight end Bruce
in the near slot. Motion Marchetti next to Flato. Takes the pass, unloads. It's wide of Barchetti. We'll bring up 3rd and long.
3rd and 13 coming up for Mamaroneck. 3:52 remaining.
Same same package again. This time they flipped the receivers back on the near side.
No Barchetti in the backfield.
Oh, that's right. They went for another,
I think,
Barchetti. Wide.
They put Barchetti wide along with
Definitely a passing down.
Connor.
They were passing
Connor's
formation.
Wide with Barchetti. You got Cotter, Barchetti, Bruce. Definitely a down to throw it. Genovese.
It's to Genovese. Okay. He's not going to get anywhere. That would bring up a fourth down and 10, maybe 9.
Good catch by Genovese. That one was low.
I thought that one might have skipped. Hard to tell from up here, but four to complete.
And 9, and we'll see the punter. Genovese will be the punter, and he looks a little gimpy after that.
So I might make you think maybe, well, he could be acting, or they could be not running a fake because of that, but they have run a fake out of this because
not
Genovese has speed.
Field position. That wouldn't be a good idea.
Genovese
good
will let it fly. Good punt's going to land near midfield.
Wow.
Fair catch.
Dangerous fair catch.
Reese Farrell Bryan.
Farrell Bryan made the catch with the defenders right near him, but they gave him the path to catch it, so.
Must have called for the fair catch. I was honestly had my eye on the ball. Wasn't looking at Farrell Bryan at that point.
It's about a 19-yard punt there. It was a smart move to fair catch it, as it looked like it was going to bounce about 10, 15 yards. Had the right spin this time. So he'll take over on the Mamaroneck side of the field, first and 10.
3:06 to go in the first half, so a little two-minute drill action coming up. See if the Rams try to throw the ball a bit, use their clock management, and get themselves close for the touchdown. They did drive the ball well their last drive, just could not get that final push near the goal line. Ball on the ground, who's got it? Abrams tried to fall back down on it, looks like he kept it.
Kept it despite the attempt to get it by Mamaroneck's.
Henry Bruce was in there.
Bruce and
someone else flew in there too.
Eddie Sirocco. Bruce, Eddie Sirocco, and Tommy Williams. Sirocco and Williams anchor that D line, both captains, second and 12.
And Bruce has really been playing well. I don't think he played a whole lot on defense before Peter Matt went down. That's usually his spot. But he's done well. Play action over the top. Incomplete. Perfect defense from Kiefer Barchetti.
Now we know why they don't throw that much. Abrams with a very high pass intended for Martin Mulvey. Mulvey almost made an Odell Beckham Jr. catch.
If there was no defender, he would have come down with it, but Barchetti came at the perfect time.
He went with one hand to bring it down, Rob. That was sick.
Everybody wants to be Odell.
Still.
I don't want to say
he was wide open.
He was open, but
I mean, but because the pass was high, it allowed Barchetti and I think Williamson to come and get swarm him quickly.
A third down and long. 2:25 to go in the half. It's a handoff. Stumbling was Levy. He'll gain about 4 yards. It'll be fourth down and 8.
J.R. Levy's first carry of the game on a big spot, third and 12. I guess they wanted to throw him out there for a little trickery, but we'll see the big-footed Ben Finkelstein here to punt. If you're Mamaroneck, I might have used a timeout there, because you can want to try and score.
Maybe they want to use them on offense.
Mamaroneck did start the game with the ball. Clarkstown North.
Sure, they won't get it back in the second half unless they onside kick it.
And that's a high snap again.
Finkelstein pulls it down.
We saw
it'll take a bounce. It'll take a Clarkstown bounce.
Wow.
It'll go down right inside the 15, right down near the 12-yard line.
15-yard bounce in favor of Clarkstown North. What a play by Finkelstein to get the very bad snap as it was high and wide. I was telling Rob during warm-ups, their long snapper looks very erratic. And so far, two of his snaps have been erratic.
They've been good enough.
1:29. That bounce in that roll took up a good 15, 20 seconds off the clock there. They must have kicked it with about 150, and now there's a 130 left.
We'll see what the Tigers do. They could run it and go to the halftime break with a lead, or they can try to put some more points up. Flato's in the gun.
It'll be from their own 13. Some roll, though, on that punt, because it was like 15, almost 20 yards.
Look
confusion from Flint, or they might have to use a timeout if they don't snap this ball really soon.
They don't want to waste a timeout, but they got to snap it. The ref is doing it,
and they do call a timeout. Maybe Flato saw something he didn't like and was trying to find the right audible. Not really sure.
Timeout number two or three.
That's right. They'll have one left. Keep in mind, if they do pick up a first down, the clock stops while the chains are moving. So that minute 29 feels a little longer than you might think.
Just like college. And especially with the running offense. Clarkstown North's offense not geared to run from their own 13 with 129 left all their runs.
Mamaroneck's offense, when you throw in eight times, Plato's about 60, 70 yards of passing already.
70 yards,
give or take. But that's a
bad timeout there.
Well, it's better than taking a penalty.
Right.
Or running a bad play, so.
But I still think should have took that timeout when they could have with 2:30 right before they punted. Because Clarkstown North took it all the way down to 150
and
20 seconds on the roll.
If they had and everything else played out the same, now they'd be down to no timeouts.
Still, with 2:10 left instead of 1:30.
Let's dial Eli Manning and see what he would have done. No, let's not do that.
I don't have him on speed dial around.
I don't yet.
Maybe.
Plato from the gun, too wide, two-man backfield. Ooh, low snap, picks it up. It's out to Genovese. Tackled right away by Kevin Sheridan. Clock will run. It'll be a second down and 12. Is not running right now. I don't know why. Now they run it just to re-spot the ball.
Genovese a little shaken up again.
As the officials have to discuss something.
Is there an issue with the clock or?
Clarkstown North has two timeouts too.
They want the clock run down. I think he's signaling towards the clock operator. Clock is running down. So
yeah, because
they noticed that it wasn't running, so good for them. But
when Rob had mentioned that it's not running, why? 55.
The refs are happy now. They'll stop it and then get set and then start it.
54. So Mamaroneck.
And here we go.
Monitoring score. Flato should have got this call there, but now he's getting it. I think Mamaroneck just wants to sit on it, Rob.
And they will, as they'll waste some time.
They might just be running this down. One run could bring them to halftime, so.
You never know, though, if you can break something.
I send Pinheiros to the other side to give to O'Rourke. Bust through, positive gain. We'll see if that'll do it for the half.
It should do it.
As it'll be third and 8 from the Mamaroneck 14. It looks like they'll just run the clock out here, and they will.
No rush to run a play. 3 seconds left on the clock, so. We told you it was going to be a defensive game, and not to pat our own backs, but we were right.
And 0-3 Mamaroneck will take 3-0 Clarkstown North team to the locker room with a 6-0 lead. That's definitely everything you want if you're in Mamaroneck. This is a team that's had a couple first-half leads in the season already and haven't come out on top, so we'll see how Clarkstown North comes out and how Mamaroneck does when we get back in the second half here on LMC Varsity Sports.
Back to the second half. Rob Moretti here along with Charlie McGraw. Tigers holding a 6-0 lead over Clarkstown North. Taking a long time in this huddle and see if there's a trick on or nope. Give Clarkstown credit, they were ready for it.
Just like the last kickoff.
So now Alvarez will line up to kick it deep.
Or squib again. And
he does roll it right up the line and falling on. Chris Petropinto, 35, who fell on it. Sorry, 55. That was Kenichi Oti.
And Coach Biddy was happy with that kick because he gave him the big pound.
It was a perfect roller, too. don't see that very often.
They've kept it away from somebody deep. They must be afraid of one of the guys deep because they squib kicked and they kicked that different kick.
The guy Leiter calls that a worm burner. No worms on this field, no, it's artificial surface.
Who calls it that?
Al Leiter?
The great one.
He is a great one.
Again, it's doing stuff in New York City.
Under center, two-man backfield. First and 10, Abrams on the keeper, far side. Hurdles a tackler, gains about three. Gets it out past the 30.
Good to see you guys.
Julian Houghton getting some secondary action here as in the first half, a couple of plays, but first two here starting in the second half is Houghton.
Second down and six. Hand off up the middle. Who's got it? It's on the far side and just able to grab the jersey with Stuart Williamson. Ball out near midfield. First down for Clarkstown North.
Orko with the run.
So much misdirection, I didn't know where the ball was, I'll be honest with you.
They've had five or six guys carry it. As Abrams, Rise, Farrell Bryan, I think, carried it once. Kyle O'Neill, J.R. Levy, Porco, and so five or six guys.
And off far side, gain of about five.
When you run so much, I mean, obviously, you're going to have different guys carry it, but definitely don't play the most exciting offense compared to Mamaroneck's. In general, it's not very exciting. Mamaroneck's very exciting for high school because high school teams don't throw that much, Rob.
Although that is trending beginning to change a little bit, but I mean,
in Texas, big powerhouses they do because they play like college.
But the more successful programs in Section 1, especially the bigger schools, do tend to throw a little more than they used to.
Like New Row.
Misdirection play. That was Porco to the far side. And
I love these double misdirections and then like the exaggerate by Abrams on the keep. But big third down here, third and four. You stop them and you bring Finkelstein on the field to punt. That would be a big start to this first half. Minute 40 gone by.
Third down and three. Up the middle, first down and more. O'Neill, tackled by the last man. Was that Houghton back there? Julian Houghton. And a nice last ditch tackle there to prevent a touchdown.
They just handed it to O'Neill up the middle. Not much misdirection on that one. He just burst through for 20.
They threw a change up there, kind of misdirecting the misdirection by not running a misdirection. That play kind of developed, I think, faster than Mamaroneck had anticipated.
Actually makes sense. 25-yard gain there for O'Neill.
He remains in the backfield for first and 10, ball just inside the 20. Abrams rolls out to throw, and is that complete? No. The target was Martin Mulvey, the tight end.
On the cover, second down 10. Williamson guarding the much bigger Mulvey. Good play there. And we see the second pass of the game, 0 for 2. As that one was more accurate, though, than the first one, as he overthrew his receiver. Mulvey, yeah, Mulvey was the one who almost made the Odell Beckham catch. So. Only target listed as a tight end, 6'3", 195.
Misdirection left side, it's Porco. He is close to a first down. He might be a yard short. It looks like they spotted about a yard short. It'll be a third down and short for Clarkstown. Chance they keep it on the ground here.
third and two almost.
Well, that sticks in the right spot. Handoff. Up the middle, they've got enough for the first down.
9-10 remaining here in the third quarter.
That was O'Neal on the carry, so. First and goal for Clarkstown North. They've been here before, and it was really that illegal shift penalty that did them in on the first drive. It turned a second and about eight into a long third down and 14.
Which was crazy because we discussed it a couple times, the illegal shift shouldn't have been called.
Or that it should have been blown dead.
Should have been blown dead, it seems, but it wasn't, and it worked in Mamaroneck's favor.
First and goal from the six. Hand off left side. I don't think he's in. He's short.
Just.
Tigers backed up against their own goal line now.
And you know it's fourth down territory from there.
Absolutely, especially down six.
Especially since they didn't kick it in the second from the six with a more than capable kicker.
So it'll be second and goal from the two.
Look out for power football here, Rob, maybe with
Porco or O'Neal.
Stack three-man backfield. It's Turneen up the middle. Touchdown, Clarkstown North.
Finkelstein
make it a one-point game. They're gonna do a
high school teams.
It's pretty common in high school.
What Mamaroneck should have done is what Mamaroneck should have done.
So Finkelstein will try the extra point. Holder is Matt Ashine. Snap is good. The kick is rolled.
The long snapper again not doing his job as it was a little low, but they have pressure. Barchetti snuck in there.
And a flag comes down now.
Also sneaking in there.
Being forced on the kickoff.
Was, I think it was Peter Bergenami.
I don't know what that flag is for, maybe.
It was Tommy Williams snap in there, but that gave the pressure, and that was Finkelstein. You saw how good he was in warm-ups. That was also a...
Well, we'll get the call now.
Pressure made him. He just hit it right into the ground in 6-6.
Well, the call went against Clarkstown North. I think that's going to push the kickoff back 5 yards. Score remains 6-6. This is going to be a fun ending to this one. It's a 15-yard penalty. Excuse me, they'll have to kick off from the 25.
Unsportsmanlike conduct.
That must be what
it was. It had to be. That is that, too. It had to be, Rob. 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, that must have been an unsportsmanlike.
This is huge from the Mariners.
A frustrated player, maybe used some language. I don't know. I didn't see any physicality.
It had to be.
So we'll see what Finkelstein decides to do. He's got a strong leg. He should just put it all into it, kick it deep. Tigers' deepest man is Zion Powell, and he's just inside the 30. Kick is deep. Powell has to back pedal. He'll kick it up from the 20.
Wow, that was some kick.
Good kick. Powell comes through. Powell, past midfield. Zion Powell with a kick return touchdown. No flags on the field. 12-6 the Mariners.
Wow, how do you like that answer? Zion Powell does not play that much defense. He had some tackles, as the official tells the Mariners sideline to get back on the sideline. And they do, but Zion Powell had a key tackle earlier and another key play, and he was untouched almost there, Rob. And unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. If that doesn't happen, that's a touchback.
Yeah, that was a serious kick, or at least it would have been by the 5.
That could have been a touchback.
He probably would have let it go.
From the 40.
You're right.
because right. he kicked it from the 25.
Right. 15, he had 15 yards of that kick.
To his own 22. He was on the 30. He had a back pedal to the 23. Had to catch it. Nice, very good catch by Powell.
So Alvarez will try the extra point.
No messing around, just kick it.
Snap good, kick is up, kick is good. And the Tigers lead 13-6. 8:03 to go in the third quarter. We'll be right back. Tigers back on top on LMC-TV. Ball on the tee. All the opponents know this Tigers scrum can result in an onside kick, so all the Clarkstown players are deep. You could try kicking over their heads if you really wanted to.
Of course, that onside kick that they did earlier in the year, first play, was Peter Mack kicked it.
And they fake it.
Ooh, wow.
That's practiced. But you can't step over the 40 or else you get an offsides penalty. And move it back 5 yards. It's still an onside kick, but it's going to go. It's going to stay in bounds. It's in!
Wow! Chetty! Wow! Kiefer Barchetti! What a kick by Alvarez! Just good enough! And this is unbelievable, Rob! Upset City coming!
And the real key to that onside kick recovery, I mean, first look at the field position. It's inside the 35-yard line. But how do you put that kind of spin on the ball where it doesn't go out of bounds? I'm not sure.
And what a kick, by
amazing that it stayed in bounds. I thought for sure that ball was going out for a flag.
First they fake it, so they don't actually do it. Then they actually do it. Ball almost goes out of bounds, and Kiefer Barchetti had a diving play, like awesome play, as the cheerleaders doing their push-ups for the scores.
I didn't know they did that. I'm finding this comical. All right. So Tigers take over. First and 10 from inside the 35. Flato in the gun. All of a sudden, they're in the driver's seat. Flato pass deflected, flag on the field. Pass hits the turf safely. We'll see what the flag is.
Mamaroneck, not sure about their road games. If they attempted any onside kicks, I don't think so, right?
Not that I've been made aware of.
I don't think they have, and they didn't score that much. They only scored 20. I mean, they had a couple opportunities, but 2 for 2 on onside kicks this year. Alvarez now 2 for 2.
How about the special teams in the last minute?
Wow. Penalty is against the Mariner.
Looks like Coach Vitti wants an explanation. Must have been, I don't know if someone jumped or if there was an illegal shift. It's going back. It's going back a lot. Moves back 15 yards. Personal foul.
Chop block.
Oh, chop block. Yeah, that's a 15-yarder.
So it'll be
first and, my goodness, 25 or so? First and 25. That's right. 15-yard penalty.
Chop block.
Flato rolls out, empty backfield, and he is sacked. Nowhere to go at Flato. That's Termine, who ran for the touchdown on the sack. Situation for that now. Okay, most importantly, their punter Genovese is out split wide right.
And that was the Robert Reamer theory, right?
He was right.
Former announcer
in the portrait. Late substitution. Nero's off for Williamson. Looks like they'll allow it.
Wow, that late is.
That's a little strange, but they'll let it work.
Flato to throw, steps up, it is a through a wobbler. They bring up fourth down, the punt unit comes out.
Good pressure there by Martin Mulvey.
Prince Emily also in on there. Genovese will.
Rob, he's got a good leg, does Alvarez. And Mike Finkelstein, I'm surprised he's not the punter.
Well, Genovese has been punting since he was a sophomore, so.
Oh, bad
snap. Skipped
it,
but he's able to pick it up. It doesn't get blocked, but it's not the best punt.
Great job by Genovese. I think now we know why.
You see where they spot that? It's out of the 35-yard line.
So that's a 12-yard punt.
Still lucky to get anything positive out of that.
Yeah. They still start on their own 35 because the way it ran out of bounds. Looked like it was a little better than that, but these officials have been very good tonight.
Yeah, if we don't mention them, that usually means they're doing a good job. We haven't really seen any questionable calls.
Yeah.
Maybe that play that we thought should have been blown dead, but maybe that's a high school rule. I'm not really sure.
It did take like 3 minutes, though, to explain it to the Clarkstown North coach. I mean,
Abrams with a late give.
Uh-oh.
Blasting up the middle is Porco. And how about that tackle?
Harden. The Harden.
Harden started it. Barchetti finished it.
I think it was all Harden. Harden brought him down, and Barchetti enough where Barchetti just was there.
Kind of grabbed him and took him down the rest of the way, but he was on his way down. You're right.
I mean, Harden. Harden, of course, the older brother of basketball star.
I think they're twins.
Oh, yeah, they are, right? Twins. And Miles. I think they're not identical. What are they?
I believe fraternal is the terminology. Hand off O'Neal. He blasts through to the second level. O'Neal still running hard. He's got a first down.
Eric Zucker took him down. Once again, get more action, and when you make a tackle like that, keep him in the game. Harden, though, has played it all, a safety. Last week, he played quarterback. The week before, he played wide receiver. In the first game, he had a couple catches. Today, we haven't seen him in wide receiver, which we thought we might since Matt's not playing.
Hand off O'Neal. I'm sorry, that wasn't O'Neal. He misdirected me again. Abrams on the keeper.
We never explained Matt. He actually got hurt on a play at New Rochelle that... At Greeley, last week that Barry, as she just walks by, athletic director Barry Sullivan explained to us that it was a play that should have been blown dead but wasn't, and when he went to make the tackle, he hurt his ankle, his left ankle.
I don't know what the diagnosis was.
One near side, sniffed out by the Tigers.
He was on crutches.
He is on crutches, so.
Might have been a fracture.
I saw him yesterday. He said it was a sprain, so. Hopefully it's not a bad sprain, and hopefully he's back soon. Definitely want him back in time for playoffs. Still 3 weeks away.
Third and three, 4:30 to go here in quarter number three.
See what Coach Trongone dials up. Misdirection, no surprise. Termine. I think he's got it. He definitely has it by a good 5 yards. That'll bring up a first and goal for Clarkstown North from the ball's on the 9. Just inside the 9-yard line.
They push her away, and she's like...
So for all the special teams action that Mamaroneck had, if Clarkstown scores here and kicks the extra point, they're all tied up.
Yeah, for sure.
Give to Porco. He pushes through for a couple yards.
Clarkstown's north, their backs are very good at getting past the initial contact. They've done a lot. Really good job of, after they got hit initially, picking up yards still. A couple times we saw that. Porco O'Neal do it good. Have done it well tonight.
Definitely all hard runners. Second down and goal from the 8. They gain a 1 on that last play. O'Neal in the backfield. Ball came to Termine. He picked up a couple.
Good job by Mamaroneck to pick that reverse up. As they went to O'Neal, the fake, the same play they ran 2 plays ago, which they got the first down off of, taken down by Kieran Quait. And it'll be 3rd and goal from the 5. Down a touchdown, even though it's the third quarter, 2:50 to go from the 5. Definitely 4 down territory, as that's what they did with earlier in the game. They went in the second quarter when we thought they might kick 4th and goal from the 6. So 3 guys in the backfield.
They're down and goal from the 5. Abrams rolls out, passes. Incomplete.
Dropped. Abrams gave him a good throw. They surprised he was wide open.
And Rise Farrell Bryan dropped it.
On a good throw by Abrams. They will go for it, as we thought. And the crowd is fired up here.
Looking for the big goal line stand. The 4th down and goal from the 5-yard line.
2:34 left here in the third quarter.
Michael Porco would not take a hit and go down there, as that is a touchdown and a huge, we're just talking about huge, 5'8", 175, Rob.
He runs a lot tougher than that.
That was huge.
So Finkelstein comes out to attempt the extra point. If successful, we'd be tied at 13.
What a game.
Snap, pull down, kick is up and good, and we are tied 13 all with 14 and a half minutes left to play. So Mamaroneck will presumably get the ball back and try to respond. It's been an eventful third quarter. It's not over yet. Stick around, we'll be right back. So Finkelstein will go back, see if they kick it deep. Join the Tigers' trickery game. Powell deep in the middle. They might, well, they'll kick it up in the air. And Powell's going to get another chance. Returned his last one back for a touchdown. Met here at around the 25, and he's brought down around the 23-yard line. That's where the Tigers will set back up on offense. Last drive after the onside kick recovery, Charlie, was really hurt by that chop block call.
Oh, yeah. On the first play after that great onside kick that was recovered by Kiefer Barchetti, the chop block made it 1st and 25. It really backed him up. And the next
two-man backfield. Pass deflected in the air and hits the turf. Plato has had a number of passes deflected to him.
Luckily, only Big Prince Amili, 6'2", 285, was the only guy in the vicinity, and it was out of his reach for him to speed on over there. That's happened a couple, yeah. Like you said, Rob, a couple times.
So 2nd down and 10, 2:15 to go, third quarter, all tied up at 13. Homecoming crowd getting a treat tonight. Flato from the gun. Quick throw dropped by Genovese.
Rare drop by Genovese. You saw him make a great touchdown catch. Two highlight reel touchdowns from Mamaroneck. Genovese on the touchdown, which is Flato's 2nd of the season.
Genovese he has been a little unsure with the, even his 2 catches were kind of bobbles. That circus touchdown catch that he did have.
Right,
it was really close to being out of bounds while he was juggling.
Made it, yeah.
So 3rd down and 10, you bet the Tigers will pass. They have.
Oh, they got
that's too many, man.
No.
Play it. I think
late substitution before
they didn't get called for.
Well, now this time they did. I knew something was wrong when they had five wide receivers and a man in the backfield. That's too many. That's 12. So.
That's too many men. On Mamaroneck should be a 5-yard penalty.
Well, Williamson just came in for.
Right, but before he did, they actually had five wide receivers. They had six eligible receivers on the field, and there should only be five. They also had Borchetti in the backfield, so.
Just a 5-yard penalty, but it doesn't help, as it would have been 3rd and 10 from the 29. Now it's 3rd and 15 from the 24.
That's from the 19. 15 from the 19-yard line. Flato from the shotgun. We'll see what they dial up. Flato with his first deep ball of the night. Incomplete. It was a little high for Genovese.
It's a good pass, though.
And he had to absorb a little contact, and that's what forced the incompletion.
Genovese is down. Down and not getting up. And we will step aside and be right back as the trainer sprints on the field here at Mamaroneck.
So Emerson Genovese able to walk off the field under his own power.
So that means Genovese can't punt.
My goodness, I didn't know Flato could punt.
What about Alvarez?
Guys, oh, Flato was going to take the snap.
Flato's the backup punter over Alvarez?
It is. Not a bad punt. Caught on the fly, fair catch by Jack Abrams, the quarterback. So both quarterbacks in on the action on that punt. Not a bad job from Flato pressed into duty.
Alvarez can't punt?
I don't know. I do know he's a converted soccer player, so maybe.
I'm gonna ask Vinny. Post game.
We'll find out.
Off the air.
So Clarkstown North will take over just under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Ball on the Mamaroneck 45.
So that was like a 25-yard punt, which I think was the longest of the night almost. Genovese's were.
So handoff up the middle, big play to the right side. That was O'Neill on the carry again.
Stuart Williamson got a piece of him, and that was just enough to take him down.
It's a first down.
And knock him into his own teammate. So we have 1:50 to go here in the third quarter. 13 apiece. A couple times to Mamaroneck tonight.
They sent a blitz. You run that risk, you send the blitz against the run, and it's a little easier for the running back to get through that first level.
Favorable spot for the Tigers. They'll
be second down and 7.
It looked like it was more like second. It would have been 2nd and 4 as another reverse.
This is Termeen. He's not close to a first down.
They love to run that reverse to Termeen. Fake to O'Neill. I mean, it's tough to pick it up even when you know it's coming, but.
Looks like we're going to have a measurement. No, it's a first down. One minute on the nose remaining in the third quarter. It's been an eventful third quarter. Two-man backfield. Keeper Abrams around the side. Finally taken out of bounds.
Lucky a late hit wasn't called on.
It was right by the sideline.
And looked like he had gotten out, and Harden took him down. The official was right on top of it. No flag.
Couldn't really see where they went. There's a big crowd all on their feet. So see where the spot is. It is a first down. And it's going to be a first and goal for Clarkstown. The last two times inside the 10, they've scored the touchdown.
First time, though, they were stopped by Mamaroneck on a fourth and goal from the 6. Sacked, actually.
Handoff met at the line. Nothing doing there.
Huge hit. That was Quate and Henry Bruce. Bruce has been playing well on defense.
Certainly.
Taking over for
Peter Matt.
Ruspin
have a lot of hits.
That was a big one, though. Second and goal. Will be the look like
just be the last play if they get it off in the third quarter.
And they have 10 seconds, so
they will.
Looks like they're going to try. Second down and goal from the 11. Termine taken down by Quaid.
Great tackle by Quaid.
And that is the end of the third quarter. We are all tied up at 13 on homecoming night of Mamaroneck. Rams driving. Fourth quarter coming up next on LMC Varsity Sports.
Back here on LMC Varsity Sports alongside Rob Moretti. I am Charlie McGraw, and it'll be a third and goal from the 7 as the two teams switch sides, and it is close, and it'll be a touchdown standing up for O'Neal. Kyle O'Neal with his first touchdown of the game, a 7-yard TD run, and third TD run, different player to score it, and power football, Rob, in and out.
That was a great run by O'Neal, too. He just refused to go down there. Had a spin move out of the way of a defender. See if Finkelstein can send another one through the posts.
So on the first play of the fourth quarter, Clarkstown North scores after scoring 13 in the third quarter. As Mamaroneck was up 6-0, Finkelstein adds the extra point to make it 20-13. As we will be right back. Back here on LMC Varsity Sports, 11:55 left following the first play of the fourth quarter. A 7-yard touchdown run from Kyle O'Neal. Third different rushing touchdown by a different player from Clarkstown North. As Termine as the kick from Finkelstein, as Termine and Porco scored the other ones. This one will be taken, and a huge hit there.
Zion Powell paying the price for that kick return touchdown he had earlier.
Yeah, he had a big hit, but going down was the guy who made the hit, was part of the hit, making the hit, was Paulie Termine.
Paulie Termine, a big part of the offense, is on the kick coverage. That's like last night in the Giants game, Rashad Jennings. You see that?
He was blocked the punt for a safety.
Right, yeah. Well, first he had the penalty. He, like, what did he do? He jumped over the back or something, or offsides. It was like a 5-yard penalty, and then he blocked the punt, but it was like, and I think that was the only time, right, he was on that punt coverage. So they'll start first and 10 from the 30-yard line, backing away from the area that's tough to see, and they'll make a catch, and a great catch on the throw by Flato. Not his best throw, as Genovese makes a great catch, redeeming himself. It'll be a first down from the 40. And Genovese will look like we kind of
nice little spin move there, too.
Got away from the defender.
Get the extra yard, get that first down.
Good start here. Flato a little off target, but Genovese, no problem.
Yeah, good stick awareness there from Genovese.
Flato will get the call. And it'll be handed off, taking down his Marchetti. And fired up is the defensive back, the big Prince Emili, 6'2", 285. That's biggest player on the field, I think.
That's a lot of happy dude right there.
For both teams, I think he's the biggest player. Although Peter Bergamini, who doesn't start for Mamaroneck, is one of the bigger players as well. But Emili of the contributors. He's been playing well, Emili, too, at defensive tackle.
Hey, he's like a little Jonathan Hankins type down there.
Yeah. Warren Sapp in him. Sappy. Great Sapp, as it'll be second and set. They spotted no loss. Looked like there was a loss at 2 or 3. But delay a game on Mamaroneck?
That's got to be what that is.
That's bad. And Vinny is not happy. Are the high school refs, they never have mics, right?
No. Wireless technology has not been embraced by the high school level. Maybe in Texas they do.
I'm sure.
Where they can build stadiums. But.
Or like when if it's a game online, on TV.
Right. So second and 15 for Mamaroneck.
Tigers have the no huddle offense.
players wear the wrist guards and they look at the play. They got to look at the sidelines. A lot of costumes running. But they run it where they delay it and they change it to sign. And
they'll get the snap and it'll be a deep pass. And it'll be, just dropped. As that would have been easy six for Mamaroneck.
But Genovese, after a great play before, that looked like it was very catchable, Rob.
And Charlie, I'm not sure that there wasn't a little contact from the defender there near the end of that route.
He definitely
slowed up a little bit. I'm not sure why, but
he was able to elude it, like get away from it so much that the refs, you know, these refs have let them play a lot, like, as well. So it'll be a big 3rd and 15 from their own 35, 10:09 to go, 20-13, Clarkstown North faking it on the pass, and they'll drop it, and it'll be fumbled and recovered by the Rams. Bad decision there, as it is dumped to Daniel O'Rourke. O'Rourke got it. He was hit at the line of scrimmage, or about a yard past it, and recovered by who else but Paulie Termine, who was on special teams making the tackle, and he had a 3-yard touchdown run earlier. And clearly it was a fumble. And that's bad, because they would punt, and the way they've been punting, they would probably have it at the 40, 35. It's a lot better than having it at Mamaroneck's 35. Rob, this part of the game we were just talking has been trouble in a lot of games. The first game we did against the Mayapak Indians, and this game, and their game against Greeley too in the fourth quarter.
And you can't really blame Flato there. He was under a rush, so he had to dump it off and hope the screen was set up. It simply wasn't.
Big hit there by the defender, Kieran Quait. Zion Powell also in on that. And that was, I think, Termine got that for minimal yardage. 3 yards.
About 3 on the play. It'll be a 2nd and 7. Stick hasn't moved yet. There it goes.
I think that guy's getting a little tired doing all the exercises. As that one will be a little miscommunication. Sack opportunity is no chance, and Powell will take him down, as they had a huge opportunity by Henry Bruce to sack him. Instead, though, Powell saves the first down from happening by taking the quarterback, Abrams, down.
And really, the key to that play was Kyle O'Neill. He threw a block on Henry Bruce in the backfield when he was going to get to Abrams, and that's why it wasn't sacked.
Also, Abrams ran into his own player, which I think was O'Neill, when he dropped back on the play. And that one will be run for a first down. Just getting it is Termine. Paulie Termine will get the first down, and it'll be 1st and 10 from the Mamaroneck 19 with the clock, as the clock will tick now with 9:11.
This is trouble for the Tigers here. They really, with that much time left, can't much afford to go down by 2 scores. But they're only about 18 yards away from having that happen.
Well, miscommunication there is coming back, is the player, Seb Damiani. Just popped. They got all the balloons set up for homecoming. And Clarkstown North, they run the perfect offense to run clock.
Yeah, that multi-headed rushing attack, it's perfect. You got a good chance to gain a couple yards and probably churn a few first downs out. But I don't think that's all they want. They want another score.
That one was fake to O'Neill, given to Paulie Termine, and it'll be a 3rd and 1 from the Mamaroneck 10.
They really need to get through the line here and make a stop, even though it's probably, you know, it might not be 4-down territory. They might opt for the field goal if they don't get the first here.
Yeah, especially with the leg.
Go up by 10.
We saw on the extra point, we saw during warm-ups. I mean, we didn't see on that other extra point because the pressure, like Marchetti, in the leg of Finkelstein, whose younger brother's on the team, Josh Finkelstein, hasn't played tackle for Clarkstown North.
It's a keeper.
It is a keeper, and it's almost a touchdown. And it is a touchdown. Abrams makes this a two-score game with 7:38 to go, and Mamaroneck needs a quick answer as they are down. Abrams, fourth different rusher to score a touchdown for the Rams from 10 and in.
That was some play, too. It was kind of a weird, a fake, like it was a broken play. The running back broke wide to the right like he was looking for a missed snap. And it worked well enough.
Ben Finkelstein on for the extra point, and it will be 2-for-3 on extra points. High snap. Kick is just good. Wobbles home. 3-for-4 now on extra points for Finkelstein. And it'll be, as we will be right back, 7:38 to go here in regulation. Here on LMC Varsity Sports, alongside community sports producer and analyst Rob Moretti. I'm Charlie McGraw. We also have cameraman Kevin Duarte, BJ Person Peary, and Juan Espinoza. As it'll be Finkelstein kicking off. 7:38 and they squib it. And will it go out? It will go out. So Finkelstein has a power leg, but he doesn't know how to squib it. That'll go to the 40.
That's right. I think they didn't want to risk kicking it to Powell again.
Yeah, they didn't want to get burned by Zion Powell because he had that big touchdown return.
And it makes sense. The last thing you want to do there is give them a touchdown and a kick return. If they're going to score a touchdown here, you at least want them to have to use the clock to get that done.
Is it just going to the 35?
I know in the NFL it's the 40. It might be a different rule in high school.
Why are they lining up so far?
I think the Mamaroneck's just in their huddle, I think.
Oh, no.
Ball is sitting on the 35-yard line, so I guess that's where
it's not in the middle of the field.
That's because that's the side that the ball went out on.
It's just the 35. It should be the 40. I think it's a 40 in the NFL. It is the 40.
I hope the officials know the high school rules better than we do.
No, I'm sure. I trust these guys. They've done good. The reverse to Barchetti will just get back to the line of scrimmage.
Might have lost a yard there.
And he stayed in bounds.
Well, there's no way around it. Mamaroneck needs to get something done on offense here. They need to score a touchdown, and they need to make a stop.
They do have their three timeouts left.
That is a good thing, but it doesn't really come into play unless they score one first.
And they got to do it quick, Rob.
7 minutes, there's time, but...
Yeah, especially with the arm of Plato.
They don't want to use a ton of time here.
Interesting play call to do that reverse. Another five-wide set. They've had that a lot with the empty backfield. Taking their time on this. They'll complete this pass. Plato getting away from it again. The first down is Williamson. Stuart Williamson. And nice play there by Williamson to break free of it. And at that angle of the field, tough to identify, but there was a nice play.
Absolutely. Made the catch. Little ducking, dodging. Dodging the wrench.
Dodgeball. Dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
You can dodge a tackler.
Yeah. So 6:40. They reset. They stop the clock when they reset. The chains. And Plato will air it out. He's got Genovese and he wins the jump ball. Good job, Emerson Genovese. That'll be a 35-yard completion to Genovese as he out jumps two defenders in Bryce Farrell Bryan and Kevin Sheridan.
That wasn't actually a great throw from Plato. A little bit of a duck, but Genovese goes up and wins the jump ball. He is a basketball player after all.
We're on the 40 now. They're on the 25. Genovese and the offense is clicking. And there's still 6:29 left. The three timeouts. Now the clock starts again as they reset. They wait for the chains to reset like in college. And empty backfield, keep that going with the five wide receivers. Plato's been pretty accurate.
He's gotten someone open on every play so far.
As we mentioned, as he keeps it,
something we didn't see. We saw earlier in the game, but not too much. 2 yard gain by Flato.
That's the beauty there, Charlie, of the five wide set is if they're all covered, there's a good chance you've got room to run.
It's only for 1 yard. But
the thing is, he's been accurate in that first game, even though he only played a half, he didn't throw an interception.
This game, that game he had them, the lead too in that.
His wide receivers, he's looking, he's going toward the end zone, over the top, and looking for the wide receiver, Connor, but great coverage by Clarkstown
North, and that was great coverage by Garza Torina and Eric Lorenzo.
Eric Lorenzo was the main guy in there and perfectly defended. He actually was in good position to try to pick that one off.
And
flags on the field. It's not a pass interference. It's back by the line of scrimmage. Well, they got the Mamaroneck for a hold or what?
Yeah.
That's...
They accepted. So the only good thing about accepting is
it's
not third and nine, so it'll be second and... All the way back there?
A lot.
Really?
Maybe it was a personal foul.
It had to be a hold, a 15-yard.
A holding is 10, so that must have been a personal foul or something.
Did he signal it yet? Here we go.
I think he's just ready to run the game. Yep. That, for 15 yards, it had to have been some sort of personal foul.
A personal foul against my Mamaroneck, back to my 15 yards. Still second down, though. Second and 25. We saw them have a first and 25 earlier, and that was trouble. This one is completed to Cotter. Cotter gets away, and he'll get a 2 extra yards on that. So it'll be, and this clock should stop. And the official is running the clock and finally stops it. 10 seconds go back. They should put 10 seconds back on the clock, Rob.
I don't think they're going to. They're just going to run it when they get back to the line or when the snap comes. But
right now. Now he waits, so that's...
The key to the message of this drive here is we don't need no stinking running backs, although Barchetti now comes into the backfield.
Third and 15. 14. After that was completed to Cotter, who's got 4 or 5 passes, a leading receiver in this one for Mamaroneck.
And it'll be Flato dropping back. Nearly intercepted by Kevin Sheridan. And he'll knock it away.
This is 4-down territory for sure.
Or it could get to Williams, so 4th and 15, and
this is your ball game right here.
Pretty much Tigers pretty much need to get the first down here. They turn the ball over on downs, and they'd have to try to force a fumble really quickly and pick it up. About 5:20 left in the game at this point.
So Flato here, and Barchetti will join him in the backfield. 4 wide receivers set, including Cotter by himself to the right. But look to the left, and he slips and falls, and that did him in. As a bad Flato slipped and fell, and it'll be a sack by the defensive tackle who's been playing great, Prince Amili.
Now, I don't know if this plays a role, but we were talking to one of the assistant coaches, David Smith, before the game, and he was pouring some water out on the field, and we thought this was strange. And he said that last night at the pep rally, they had thrown some sort of powder on the field that had made the field slick.
He was like baby powder.
And he was trying to wash it away. He didn't put any water in that area. I don't know. Again, I don't know if that played a role or if Flato just slipped.
Yeah, he might have just slipped. It's turf, so there shouldn't be many slips.
They need to stop him here quickly.
Let's give it up for our cheerleaders.
Down North will take over on their way to improving to 4-0.
This is the most points they've given up in a game so far, so
by 5 points.
Encouraging sign if you want to take it.
It would be the closest margin of victory, too. And that one will be stopped at the line of scrimmage. Easy.
You
can see they're swarming to the ball and just trying to rip it out. They need to force a fumble. Well, they just keep tackling for
loss. Too early to call your three timeouts. I mean, you got to wait a little bit.
Yeah, and the real problem is that they need two scores. If they needed one, you'd say they're still in okay shape as long as they can make the stop.
That looked like a loss of at least two.
But must have given them forward progress.
In high school, the game clock is 40?
Play clock?
Play clock.
I think it's 40.
Yeah, 40. Wow. Basically, that's what you can, 38 is what you can take off
every play, and that's what they'll do.
They'll reverse it, though. Mamaroneck just picks it up, and he can break free, and he'll get a first down and more. And that is the running back, Porco, who had a five-yard touchdown run. And same play, killing Mamaroneck on this reverse. He did get out, though, so that should stop the clock.
It does. It's the only positive from Mamaroneck on that play.
4:15.
It's starting to get late from Mamaroneck here.
Still have that four-minute warning in high school?
Yes, they do. So we are approaching that. Another additional timeout.
Yeah.
But the Tigers need to make a stop. They need the ball back, and they need to advance the ball down the field quickly.
There's only one fumble in the game that Mamaroneck recovered. Mamaroneck fumbled it once. That Clarkstown North. Correct? Yeah.
That is correct. I think it was O'Rourke on that fourth down play, that little screen right. play that never really developed.
Oh, and then there was a recovery. I think Barchetti recovered
the onside kick.
There was a fumble recovery, I think, no?
I don't think so.
No, you're right.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Rob, there is no four-minute warning. Is there?
I thought there was. I think they're signaling it now. The clock is running, so...
I can never figure out that.
They called it the Ryanek game last week, so I can never figure out what's going on with that.
So it'll be a 2nd and 7. They'll reverse again, and it'll beat them again. Another first down for Clarkstown North. Same play. Mamaroneck can't solve the play. The reverse, and Porco gets it and gets 10, 15 yards. Not good, Rob.
And the real problem is that Clarkstown North is running the misdirection offense just to perfection. Every play looks exactly the same until a different guy has the ball, and it might be too late at that point for you to recover and pick him up.
Like we said, it's not the most exciting play.
But it's effective, especially
sure.
when it's run like this. They're running to perfection.
The beginning of the game, the first quarter or so, and after that, you and I were both, that one will be run up the middle. By O'Neal, that we were both befuddled by the fact that they were 3-0, because the way their offense was running and they did not look like an undefeated team.
Well, they're the old school ground and pound, play good defense, and you can win that way, obviously. Clarkstown North, a little over 2.5 minutes away from going to 4-0.
Again, this time picked up, and it'll be that was Termine tackled by
That was Quate. It was a nice hit by Quate.
Very good hit by Quate.
And the one positive for Mamaroneck, though, is they are going to make the playoffs. It's kind of it hurts to say it when you're 0-4, but preseason top 13. They could be as low as a 13 seed in that first round, but they're still going to get to play a game in the playoffs. Anything can happen.
Which has to do with them being rewarded. Last year they had a good season.
Exactly.
They didn't call timeouts here, and they'll run it. Termine gets by the possible defender, and he'll approach the chains.
They're stopping the clock, so either got it or they want to measure. Looks like he got it.
Getting shaken up was Tommy Williams.
They'll bring in the backup, Julian Aversano.
So the chains haven't moved, but the down marker is in the right spot. 1st and 10 from the 15.
No timeouts by Vitti. They'll just let it run.
figure if you're somehow going to pull this one out, you're going to need the timeouts later.
He didn't even call timeout for the injured player. I mean, I think they stopped the clock when he came off the field. That one will be run up the middle once again. This is Kyle O'Neill with the carry, and he gets 5 yards. It'll be 2nd and 5 from the Mamaroneck 10.
Down near a minute to
Clarkstown
go.
Clarkstown North, just take a knee. Why are you running the ball? Right?
They like to run the ball, though.
So, you got... I think they are going to take a knee, and they will, finally.
I told them.
And they're going to need one more knee to run out the clock.
You have to take a knee there, because if you score, that's bad. That looks like it's bad sportsmanship. Even, you know, up that much.
Oh, certainly agreed. Up I mean, two scores
even
this
though,
much
yeah,
time
yeah,
left.
I mean, they realized. 27 seconds.
Yeah, this last knee should do it, unless the Mamaroneck decides to suddenly use their timeouts.
They won't. Vitti, Coach Anthony Vitti has thrown in the towel. So we'll interview him and do post-game analysis coming up.
And that'll do it.
That'll run off the clock, and that'll be the game. As Clarkstown North wins this one by a score of 27-13. Another tough loss for Mamaroneck, Rob.
Absolutely, and it was so encouraging. Middle of that third quarter, they scored that touchdown on the kick return, and they recovered the onside kick. They had all the momentum, and then something as simple as a chop block 15-yard penalty stalls that drive, and it was all Clarkstown North from that point on.
Four different players scoring rushing touchdowns. Jack Abrams, Paulie Termine, and Kyle O'Neill, and Michael Porco, all from 10 yards and in, too. As where Mamaroneck had the nice touchdowns of a 67-yard kickoff return and a great catch by Emerson Genovese from Bill Flato. Good to see Bill Flato back, though.
Oh, absolutely. He was throwing the ball well. Well, if the Tigers can just get all their pieces back, if Peter Mack can heal his ankle quickly, and if they can have a full attack on offense where you don't have to just play the pass or just play the run, we haven't really seen this offense at full speed yet, and hopefully we get a chance before the end of the year.
Definitely impressive offense by Clarkstown North. As when we get back, we'll have the post-game analysis and interview with Coach Vitti here on LMC Varsity Sports.
Back here with Coach Anthony Vitti. And Coach, it was a tough loss for you guys, but you guys started off well against one of the best teams in the section.
We knew this was going to be a stiff, stern test for us. That's a really good unit across the way. Clarkstown North's been doing a great job this year. Had a chance to see them live a few times, and they're a really talented team, and I'm proud of our guys for stepping up and fighting with all they had tonight.
And it was a tough loss, a second half loss again. What do you think you guys have to do to finish games off better?
You know, we just got to keep playing. You know, it's the plan's good. You know, we like what we do. We practiced real hard this week. The kids were full of energy. It really just comes down to, you know, continuing to make adjustments, to continue to play to the scheme, and just finishing.
And quarterback Bill Flato looked good after missing 2.5 games. Yeah. How key is he for you guys?
Oh, he's a trigger man. You know, he's when the sheriff's back in town, things change. And Bill's been very good for us for 3 years. And he knows what he's doing within the scheme of our offense. And he did a great job tonight. Very little rust after not playing for 2.5 games.
And lastly, what do you think the team has to do to get that first W?
We just got to keep playing. You know, that effort that you saw out here tonight is going to get a lot of W's. You know, again, that was a very good football team. I think it was a well-played football game. And ultimately, we just got to keep fighting and grinding. And I know that tomorrow, I tell our kids, the sun will be out, the sky will be blue, and the grass will be green, and we'll be out there working.
Back here on the post-game show after the 27-13 win by Clarkstown North over Mamaroneck. And Rob, a good start for Mamaroneck once again, but they had trouble finishing this game off.
Yeah, the 6-0 lead at halftime, then they go out 13-6 after the great kick return touchdown after the first Clarkstown North score.
It looked like they had all the momentum, and just like I said at the end of the game, as soon as they recovered that onside kick and there was that 15-yard penalty to start that drive, it just, I don't know if there was an emotional letdown or what, but it looked like that the wheels just came out from under them at that point.
And Clarkstown North, once that happened too, we saw the team that was undefeated, 3-0, now 4-0. Their offense was pretty tough for Mamaroneck to handle.
When a team runs a misdirection offense like that, and it's run to deceptively to that amount, it can be really hard to pick up, especially when they have that many threats who can run well.
Yeah, so it was another tough loss for Mamaroneck, and it'll be a tough hill for here to climb. But like we said, they automatically qualify for the playoffs, so that's a bright note to look on. As a lot of people to thank for today's telecast, including the executive director, Eric Lewis, associate director, Matt Sullivan, community sports producer, Mr. Rob Moretti, for our cameraman, DJ First Imperi, Juan Espinoza, and Kevin Duarte. Once again, the final score was 27-13, and thanks again to Rob Moretti. I'm Charlie McGraw saying thanks so much for watching, and have a great evening. We'll be right back.